Now we are going to discuss the relationship between the structures and the functions. That is, how to pass a structure to a function, right? And how to return a structure from a function. So when you pass a member of a structure to a function, you are actually passing the value of that member to a function. So by default, you pass the individual members of a structure to a function. Okay. And the passing is happening through value, pass by value, right? So let us take an example. We have a structure fret, and the fret structure contains four variables, character x, integer y, float z, and character string s. So what is this? This is s means this is an array. Okay. And its data type is char. So it means this is a string. Char array is also called a string. And the size of this string is 10 variables. Okay, 10 values can be stored. 10 characters can be stored in this string. Okay. And one new thing which you might note here is that we are writing the variable name here. Okay. Normally in the previous programs we wrote fred then space mike to create the structure variables. Okay. So this statement created a structure variable mike whose data type was fred. But we can also do this. Okay. So before the semicolon and after the closing curly brace, you can write the name of the variable. This also creates the variable mike of type fret, right? So this is another syntax which you can use. Both these and this thing, they are same. Okay. So how to pass the variables which are members of this structure to a function? Suppose the name of the function is func, func, and how to pass x, write the name of the variable, structure variable, then dot operator, and then the member name. Okay. So mike.x. So this will pass the value of x to the function func. Okay. So the function func, how can you define this function so that it receives this value? Can you write int x? Yes, of course, you can do this. Because what is this? This is a value. Although this is the value of a member of a structure, this is just an integer value. Okay. And you can write an integer as a parameter of the function to receive this value. Okay. So this is valid. Similarly, mike.y can be passed. Okay. Sorry, this x is not an integer, this x is a char. So you need a character to receive that value. Okay. So func2, it is mike.y. So in order for func2 to receive this value, we need a integer, int y, suppose. Okay. Then float z, func3 will have a float parameter, float z. And then func4, what are we doing here? This is important. Here we are passing mike.s. What is s? S is an array. And what is the name of s? Name of the s is base address of the array. So here we are not actually passing the value, we are passing the address. Okay. So in the function definition, what do we need? We need something which can receive an address. So what is that thing which can receive an address? A pointer can receive an address. So we here need a pointer in star. So whatever is the base address of this string or this character array, that will be stored in pointer p. Okay. And if you like to pass individual character in the string, you can write mike dot s. Suppose you want to pass the character at index 2, then write s2. Okay. And in this case, the function definition will need just a character to receive this character passed by the function call. Okay? So, if you wish to pass the address of an individual structure member, you can put the ampersand before the struct name. Okay? So, here is an example. So, here we are passing by address. Okay? We are passing the addresses. So, if you pass by value, you just write mic.x. But how to pass the address? The address of operator, then mic.x. In this case, the function definition just needed a character because x was a character. But in this case, the function definition will need a pointer to a character because we are passing an address. Okay? Similarly, we are passing the address of an integer y, we are passing the address of a float z, but here we do not need to write the ampersand because the name of the array, because s is not a normal variable, this is an array, this is an array, okay. So the name of the array is actually the address of the array, so by default you are passing the address. Okay, so this is always called by address. So we are passing the address of string s, and as I told you, in the function definition, we need a pointer to receive this address. And the data type of address pointer is char. Why? Because s is a string, s is a character array, right? And when you want to pass the address of an individual character in that string, then you write ampersand mic.s2. Okay. So, ampersand operator here precedes the structure name, not the individual number name. Okay. So, this is an important thing. Ampersand mic.x. This is not that you write mic.ampersandx. This is wrong. Okay. So ampersand is before the name of the structure. Okay. So this is now an example how to pass an entire structure to the function. In the previous examples, we discussed how to pass the members of a structure to a function. Now, how to pass an entire structure to a function. So here we are creating a structure. Struct type, then it is having three variables, int a, int b, and charch. Okay, so here we have a function where f1 is the name of the function, and this is the function declaration. So what are the arguments which we can pass to this function? We are passing the structure. So we write struct and the struct type and the variable. Okay, just like we write int a in the function declaration void f. Okay, same thing is what we are doing here. We are writing struct type. This is the type of the structure equivalent to integer and then the name. Okay, so this is equivalent to a. And in main, what are we doing? We are creating a variable of this structure, struct type, and the variable name is arg. Arg.a is equal to 1000. So we are initializing the member a. And then we are calling the function f1 and we are passing this structure, entire structure, as an argument. Okay, so how to pass an entire structure as an argument? Just type the name of the structure. Okay, so here the name of the structure is arg, so we are writing arg here. And here in the function definition, we have this structure. This arg will be received by this structure, and we are naming it as parm. Okay, and then cout parm.a. So in this way, we are able to access this structure. Okay. So let's copy this code and try to implement it. So we have our structure here. Okay, then we have the main function and the function f1. Okay. So here, let's first try to run this, then we will modify it a bit. Okay. So 1000 is being printed. Why? Because we are passing the structure as an argument here, and then we are using the number access operator dot the variable name to print the value of variable a. So the value of variable a is 1000, that is why this statement is giving us the value 1000. Okay. So can we skip the keyword struct here? Let's try to do this. So I have erased the redundant keyword struct. I have just written the tag of the structure. What is the tag of the structure? Tag of the structure is struct type. Okay. And then the variable name. The variable name which is passed to the function is param. And here also we have written param. And here we have created the variable r. Okay. So we can skip the keyword struct when you are creating a variable of the structure. Okay. And is it compulsory to mention the parameter here? Name of the parameter here, we can skip this also. Okay, so when you are declaring the function, here we are declaring the function, you just need to mention the data type of the parameter. Okay, you do not, this is redundant, you do not need to write a name also. Okay, you can skip this also. Anything else which we can do? So let's check, are we passing this structure by reference or by value? Okay, so how can we check this? We can check this by checking the memory address of the structure. So here we are creating the structure arg. Okay, and let us try to print the address of arg. Address of arg. How can we print the address of arg? Ampersand arg. Okay. So this will give us the address of arg. And here we are passing this arg to this function. And here we are creating another variable param. So let's try to print the address of param. Address of arg is different than the address of param. It means that we are passing by value. Okay. So here we are passing the values which are there in arg. And these values are copied in structure param. Okay. So these are two different structures, and we are copying the values of one structure arg into the values of the other structure param. Okay, pass by value is going on here. Now let's move forward. Here we have another example. So this is an incorrect example. This program is incorrect and will not compile. This is just to make the things clear to you. So here again we have the same structure, struct whose tag is struct type, and it has the same variables int a comma b and char ch. Now what are we doing here? We are defining the structure similar to struct type but with a different name. Okay. So this structure and this structure, they have same members int a comma b char ch, but this has name struct type and this has struct type 2. Okay, So this F1, now what is it doing? It is using a variable as a parameter of struct type 2. Okay, not of this type, but of this type. Okay, and here what are you doing? We are creating a variable of struct type that is of the first structure whose name is arg. We are initializing the member a equal to 1000 and we are passing arg. Okay, but what will happen? The compiler will give you an error if you try to do this. Why? Because although the members in both the structures are same, okay, their structure is same, but the type is different. Here we are passing the structure of struct type, but this function F1 is expecting a structure of struct type 2. Okay, so therefore this program will not compile.